Hi guys, and welcome back to our Kiteloop tutorial. Today we're going to be talking about Kiteloops with a jump. It's really important to understand that there are two kinds of loops, low-powered and high-powered ones. Low-powered loop, also known as a heli loop, is the one you want to learn first. It is initiated in the very end of the jump, on landing. The kite stays at the edge of the wind window during the loop, providing a small amount of vertical pull, which is usually used to soften the landing after a high jump with a small kite. Almost no horizontal pull is delivered. Usually it has a small radius, actually you don't have much time before the landing for a slow big loop. High powered loop happens earlier during the jump, soon after the liftoff or at the apex point. The kite is traveling closer to the center of the wind window and delivers a lot of horizontal pull. Depending on how hard you steer the kite, the radius can be either big or small. High-powered kite loops with biggest radius possible are known as mega loops. Remember one thing, the power of your kite loop mostly depends on how early you pull the bar. Shooting your bar in or out affects just the radius of your loop. Only the moment of pulling the bar determines what kind of loop you'll get, high or low powered. I often get questions like what kind of kite is better for learning kite loops. To make it easier, let's define two groups: freeride flat kites and freestyle C-like kites, including hybrids. Both kinds have lifting and turning areas on the canopy. When you steer the kite to make a turn or a kite loop, it gets twisted a bit, exposing the turning area to the airflow. The pressure on one side of the kite increases and forces the kite to turn. C-type kites have much bigger turning area, which allows them to turn faster. Besides, when the C-kite is put to the center of the wind window while it loops, the rising pressure of the airflow increases both traction power and the ability of C-kite to turn. With freeride kites, the traction power is increased much more than the turning ability, corresponding to lower percentage of turning area on the canopy. That's why freeride kites turn much slower when they are overpowered and are not suitable for high-powered kite loops. Most of freeride kites will have a huge radius and excessive horizontal pull if you try a high-powered kite loop riding them, which is very dangerous. However, every modern kite of any size is still able to do a nice low-powered heli loop. So, you can take any kite to learn your first heli loops, but be sure to switch to some freestyle sea kite in case you want to progress to high-powered kite loops. You have to master three important skills really good before trying a kite loop with a jump. Pointing your board downwind on landing is the most important one, the key to your safety. If you get too much pull from the kite, going downwind will help to get rid of this power easily. If you land with your board not pointing downwind, it can skid, sometimes causing a hard crash. Be sure to have enough practice with this skill, don't hesitate to put your board parallel with the wind. It's never too much of downwind travel when landing after a hard kite loop. Work until this skill becomes your instinct. Don't try to do a kite loop with a jump without getting used to steer your kite really hard to loop. Be sure to check episode 1 if needed. Small radius kite loops are safer and have less power, because in this case your kite doesn't travel too far inside of the wind window. Be sure that you are not feeling like letting your bar go in the middle of the loop, because it's the worst thing you can do. Keep pulling the bar hard until the loop is done. You have to be able to keep your kite staying stable at 12 o'clock while you are descending. It's gonna be your starting position for initiating the loop. You can see me here steering my kite a bit forward to 12 to prevent it from going too far to the right side before the loop. So, do not initiate your kite loop if your kite is traveling across the wind window too fast, staying far to the left or to the right, or you don't feel stable hanging under it. As we start with a low-powered heli loop, the main key point is to pull the bar for the kite loop as late as possible, just before the landing. The thing is that as soon as you lift off the water, you have no more grip with the surface and your body is being blown downwind. At the same time, your kite goes upwind a bit because it has all your weight on the lines. As a result, longer you're hanging there on your lines, more you shift downwind, having your kite closer to the edge of the wind window. They say that the kite is trying to fly behind your head. So, if you pull your bar late, when the kite is already at the edge of the wind window, the loop will have less power. Here is your starting position for the kite loop. Right before the landing, on the way down from your jump, having your kite stable around 12. When you feel comfortable with getting into your starting position, you can think about what to try first. A down loop, a kite loop, or a kite loop transition. It doesn't really matter which one you choose, just do what you feel like more. Down loop may be a good option because you already have the feeling of looping the kite that way, if you had enough practice with surface downloops. If you want to try a kite loop instead, it may be better to practice it on the surface first. Choose a light wind day for that. Rules are the same as for the surface downloop, but be sure to steer your kite really gently and slowly across 12 to avoid lifting off the water. You also have to drive your board much more downwind if compared to the downloop exercise, even changing direction for a while. Also, watch your line's tension really carefully and keep it in normal range by pointing your board downwind less or more. If you want to try a kite loop going really slow before the jump, a kite loop transition may be a good choice. You already have the feeling of changing direction with a kite loop from episode 1. So, the only thing left is to add a jump to that one. For your first attempt, choose medium wind, avoid being fully powered. Ride with low speed, go for your jump. It is really important to jump from the most upwind course possible for you with your lines tensioned to bring your kite to the edge of the wind window from the beginning. You can find more tips on how to do that in one of the next episodes. Now, reach the right moment to initiate the loop. It has to be after you pass the apex of your jump on your way down. Remember, it's not about the height where you pull the bar, it's about timing. Later you pull it, softer the kite loop is. Don't forget to stabilize your kite around 12 o'clock before pulling the bar. After you pull the bar hard, keep it like that until your kite finishes the loop. Simply forget about the bar and concentrate on turning your board downwind for landing. Your kite crashes the water, or the loop is so big that you are often about to crash. One possible reason is that you are trying to make the loop softer, so you steer the kite gently or even let the bar go. I strongly recommend you to get back to episode 1 and practice surface loops with aggressive steering again and again until your muscle memory gets the rule. Harder you steer the kite, safer you are. Another reason for a bigger radius could be pulling the bar too early. Be sure to initiate the loop after you pass the apex of your jump, especially if riding a slow turning free ride kite. Often people are afraid that the kite won't finish the loop before they hit the water. Don't worry about that. You can see here the kite loop happening actually after the landing, and I'm still okay. In this case, your kite loop with a jump turns into a normal surface loop. So, you can just keep doing the same you do for the surface loop, pulling the bar hard, pointing the board downwind, and waiting for the kite to finish the loop. Sometimes you do everything right, pulling the bar hard and light enough, but your kite still pulls you hard while it loops. Usually, the reason is that you don't have opened enough before the jump and you don't have enough board grip to provide you with good tension in your lines. As a result, everything happens with your kite sitting quite deep in the wind window with lots of power. To be sure, go for a couple of your normal jumps. If you've been dragged downwind too much on landing, like this, then this is your case. I will post a special episode about fixing this issue so that you can jump more like this. For now, just start with trying to go as much upwind as possible before you jump. We'll work on your stance and jumping techniques more detailed really soon. So, go out there, choose the type of kite loop you want to try first and practice hairy loops really a lot. Next time, we'll take a closer look at high-powered kite loops and ways you can use kite loops to improve your tricks.